Welcome to Taps Field Hockey 2019 here from San Antonio, Texas. We appreciate you joining us on Taps TV today. We will have the St. Agnes Tigers. They're going to be in the black uniforms with gold numbers, and we're going to have the Duchesne Chargers. They're going to be white with blue numbers here in semifinal number two. It's the number two and three seeds as we go forward with our tournament this year. Again, we appreciate you joining us. We're live from San Antonio, Texas at St. Mary's Hall. We appreciate them hosting our tournament this year, and we look forward to a great game here momentarily. We're 10 minutes away from introductions. Thank you again for joining us on Taps TV.
Time. Just a reminder from Taps that the Field Hockey Championships are taking place Friday, October 25th and Saturday, October 26th. More of your favorite music is coming up for you here on Game Time. She got the best of me. She broke my heart and all that's left of me is beating this guitar. Thank you again for joining us on Taps TV for Taps Field Hockey 2019, our second semifinal of the day. The Chargers of Duchesne Academy, they'll be in white. And the Tigers of St. Agnes Academy, they'll be wearing the black uniforms today. Joining us here in San Antonio, Texas, where it's 61 degrees. We do have a 17-mile-an-hour north wind, so that's affecting the chill factor a little bit. Hasn't affected play in the first game very much, so we look forward to another great contest here coming up. Taps Field Hockey 2019 is going to be semifinal number two. Duchesne Chargers, St. Agnes Tigers coming your way shortly. Thank you for joining us on Taps TV.
Sky, please tell us why you had to hide. and running and running 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 running and in this context there's no disrespect, so when I bust my rhyme you break your necks. We got 5 minutes for us to disconnect from all intellect and let the rhythm affect. The inhibition, follow your intuition, free your inner soul and break away from tradition. Cause when we be out, girl, it's full of heat out. You wouldn't believe how we wow. Turn it till it's burned out, turn it till it's turned out. Act up from Northwest East side. Everybody, everybody, let's get into it. Get stoned, come on, get it started, come on, get it started. Take it slow, don't get ahead, just jump into it. Y'all hear about it, the P's will do it. Get started, get stupid. Don't worry about it, people will walk you through it. Step by step like an infant new kid. Inch by inch with a new solution. Transit hits with no delusion. The feeling's irresistible and that's how we move it. Yo, everybody, everybody, let's get into it. Get stupid.
Thanks again for joining us here for Taps Field Hockey 2019. Semifinal number two is the Houston Showdown between St. Agnes and Duchesne. We'll be coming to you shortly. We're getting ready for pregame introductions. Appreciate you joining us on Taps TV for this year's contest. Semifinal number two to see who's going to advance to the winner's bracket and play for the championship against Fort Worth All Saints, and who's going to go to the third place game and play against the host St. Mary's Hall Barons. Again, we appreciate you joining us on today's telecast and appreciate, as always, your support of Taps and Taps TV.
Good afternoon, fans, and welcome to Lewis Field at St. Mary's Hall for the Texas Association of Private and Parochial Schools Field Hockey Championship Tournament. For today's second semifinal game, we have Duchesne Academy of the Sacred Heart Chargers and the St. Agnes Tigers. And now, introducing the starting lineup for Duchesne. Number 16, Mary Armentor. Number 2, Sarita Arsham. Number 10, Julia Cook. Number 5, Caitlin Gilmore. Goalie, Camille Loeb. Number 38, Jenna Montalbano. Number 18, Meta Sapien. Number 23, Ariel Schumacher. Number 34, Cece Van Pelt. Number 27, Barrett Wickman. Number 33, Safia Zaman. Duchesne is coached by Jen Bauer, and her assistants are Cody Moles and Tiffany Sutton. And your starters for the St. Agnes Tigers. Number 2, Emily Schroeder. Number 3, Sarah Tidwell. Number 6, Grace Ann McGee. Number 11, Abby Kraft. Number 12, Addie Paradise. Number 13, Mimi Reedy. 14, Jacqueline Sellers. Number 18, James Trammell. Number 21, Sadie Niermeyer. Number 22, Hope Anderson. And number 90, goalkeeper Hannah Hurey. St. Agnes is coached by Tiffany Deinzer and assistant coach Lindsay Jolando. And now we invite everyone to please stand for our national anthem.
Thank you again for joining us for Taps Field Hockey 2019 here from San Antonio, Texas. This is semifinal number two. The Duchesne Chargers and the St. Agnes Tigers are getting ready to take the field and take action. Duchesne wearing white going from left to right. St. Agnes wearing black. They'll be going from right to left. There is a 20-mile-an-hour gusting wind coming out of the northwest, which brings it right across both benches to the far side of the field. There will be a slight tailwind for the St. Agnes Tigers and a headwind for the Chargers. Looking forward to the first 30 minutes. We're getting ready on the whistle. We will begin play. Timer's ready, officials ready, and play has begun. Chargers with possession and the attack. Chargers will again control when the ball goes out of bounds. Tigers bring the ball up the near side. Tigers retain possession on the whistle. In goal for the Chargers, we have Camille Loeb. And in goal for the Tigers, we have Hannah Hearing in goal for the Tigers. Both teams continue to bandy possession around the middle of the pitch. Duchesne coming on the tack, looks to center. Had a good look. She was looking for number 38. Unable to connect. That's Jenna Montabano. She had positioned herself well in front of the goal. Number 34 for Duchesne, moving in with the attack. That was C.C. Van Pelt. Keeper stayed relatively calm on that attack. Good job of the defense in front of her. St. Agnes attempts to move forward. Controls on the near sideline. On the whistle, will maintain possession. Starting play again. Move forward. Good attack that time by number 21 for the Tigers. That's Sadie Niermeyer. Duchesne looks to bring it back the other way. Nice little play by Trammell there to move the ball forward. See if number two can catch up on the far side. Duchesne coming down the near side. That was number five pushing the action. Number five is going to be Caitlin Gilmore. She's been pretty active so far in the early goings of this game. 5 minutes in, we're at the 25-minute mark. 5 in, 25 to play here in the first half. Both teams have moved forward. Looking to reverse field that time with number 23 for Duchesne. Broken up nicely by the St. Agnes defense. It's going to be number 12, Anna Paradise, moving the ball forward. I think she was looking for 21. Instead, she found number 11, Abby Kraft. Kraft will reset. Bring us back into the action here. On the whistle, Agnes retains possession. Was a good feed from Kraft to Paradise, but unable to get it back to the middle. Duchesne turns the field quickly. Good defense causes her to slow down. St. Agnes retains possession. On the whistle, possession stays with Duchesne. Shin continues attacking down the far sideline. Montalbano's moving towards the middle. That's number five. Moves forward. Good save there. Good kick away by number 90, the goalkeeper. Anna Huron did a good job that time, manifesting a good defense. Pays off. St. Agnes unable to clear. Chargers looking to attack. As number 10, that was Julia Cook on the attack. It's number 23 for the Chargers. That's Ariel Schumacher. Resets and gets ready for play. Back into the action, return to Schumacher. Good drive to the middle. That was number 34 for the Chargers. CC Van Pelt continues on this near side again with the look for the shot, unable to connect. See if St. Agnes can turn the field. Balls move forward. Good defense that time by number 18 for Duchesne. Number 18 is Metasapien. Ball sent out on the far side. Referees confer. Possession stays Duchesne. St. Cy and Agnes. We'll see what they can get started here on the far side. Wind at their back. Again, 60 degrees outside, but the wind is 17 to 25 coming from that right to left side. Makes it a little tougher get the focus at times. Officials doing their job and the players doing theirs. We've got possession to St. Agnes. And just that quickly, possession goes over to Duchesne. Checking our clock, 19:35 remaining here in the first half. 19:35 remaining in the first half of the semifinal contest between the Duchesne Chargers and the St. Agnes Tigers. It's number 23 for Duchesne, keeping the possession in play. She's worked hard on this near side this afternoon. Number 23 is Ariel Schumacher. Again, sends it in deep. Chase is back, just barely missed. Teammate maintains control. Two Tigers this time searching for the ball. A little aggressive there. Brings the ball back to the Chargers. 23, Ariel Schumacher. Sets and ready for play. Grace Ann McGee comes off the pitch for the Tigers. Number 15, Olivia Walden, enters play. Good job that time by the St. Agnes defense. It's number 22. That's going to be Hope Anderson. Continues moving forward. Good job on defense to stop play. They've been playing a lot in the St. Agnes half this time. First quarter continues to roll. 17 minutes and 45 seconds. 17:45 remaining in the first half. Number 11, Abby Kraft, coming off the pitch. And we're going to have number 8, Augustina Urkola, entering the game. Let's see what Agnes can mount here. Duchesne continues pushing forward. Good job by Agnes to break that up. Agnes on the attack. It's number 21 for St. Agnes. Sadie Niermeyer. Good job pushing the action forward. As number 2, Sarita Arsham exiting the game for Duchesne. Agnes almost able to keep it in play. Possession will go over to the Chargers. Agnes continues, see if they can get the ball as he plays through. Good offensive possession here. That's number eight. That's Arcola. She turns, makes the drive, unable to connect. On the whistle, possession goes over to Duchesne. Arcola's presence immediately felt as she came down this near side, then was able to make the drive towards goal. Duchesne loses the possession to the sideline. Agnes looks like they have subs coming in. Chargers making a run. Maintain possession on the whistle. Slows down play. Looking for number five on this near side. Unable to connect with Caitlin Gilmore. St. Agnes continues play. Arcola moves forward to number 12. 12 to number 15. 15 continues to battle to 21. 21 is Sadie Niermeyer. Unable to control. Arcola drives from deep. Duchesne able to control with defense. Out of bounds off of the Agnes Tigers. Number 9, Christina Ohayoff, and number 11, Abby Kraft have entered the pitch for the Tigers. After that exchange, Duchesne moves forward, looking for Gilmore, who struggled there. Arcola looks to set us for play again. Good defense by number 23. That's Arielle Schumacher. She's been very active this afternoon as well. A lot of action here in the first half. A lot of up and down. 12 minutes and 10 seconds remaining. Our score 0-0. The Houston Field Hockey Showdown. You've got the St. Agnes Tigers in black. And in white, you have the Chargers from Duchesne Academy. Drive goes through. Good defense that time by the Chargers. Number 21 for St. Agnes was able to move forward. Good job of 21. Sadie Niermeyer forcing the action. On the whistle, possession goes over to Duchesne. Arcola. Again drives deep. That's number 12 for St. Agnes. That was Addie Paradise. Unable to catch up. Go, 11 minutes, 10 seconds remaining here in this first half. 11-10 in the first half. Here's Arcola. Officials get her figured out. She gets it set. She was looking for number 15, looking for a teammate there, Olivia Walden. Arcola again drives backwards this time to number 22. Fails to connect on the stick. That was Hope Anderson. She was looking to reset and then come down the near sideline. Gilmore sends it back into the pitch. That's bead number 38. That'd be Montalbano. No, I'm sorry. Yes, that would be Montalbano trying to move the ball forward. It was number 10 on the attack. That's Julia Cook. Good fight on the far side by Abby Kraft for St. Agnes. She continued for quite a ways. Finally loses possession to Duchesne. See if Duchesne can mount a charge here with 9:50 left in the first half. 9:50 remaining. Ball goes over the sideline. We have Urkola here to set us back into play. Kind of like that ball down the first baseline. It just kept going out and never did recover. We have a timeout on the pitch. Timeout Duchesne. We have 9:35 remaining in the first half. Thank you for joining us on Taps TV for the Taps Field Hockey 2019 tournament. Today's second semifinal between Duchesne and St. Agnes is tied 0-0. Thank you again for joining us on Taps TV.
I think that high school sports have made me physically and mentally tough. Sports have taught me through good times and bad times that you have to keep your head up and stay tough and keep working harder to get better.
Still tied 0-0. Both teams having possessions. Very few shots compared to last game here in the first half. Both teams playing hard. Midfielders do an excellent job of changing possession at all opportunities. Good defense by both clubs. St. Agnes Tigers 0. Duchesne Chargers 0. Duchesne in white moving from left to right. And St. Agnes in black moving from right to left. The wind's still moving 20 to 25 miles an hour at times. It's been a consistent 15 miles an hour all day. Our temperature's in the mid-60s, so a little challenging on the weather front, but our young ladies are doing an excellent job today. Appreciate you joining us on Taps TV for Taps Field Hockey 2019 here in our second semifinal of the day. As we approach the 9 minute to play mark in the first half, St. Agnes looks to put the ball in play. Number 21 moving the ball for Agnes. That's Sadie Niermeyer. Good job continuing on the attack. Good defense that time. Good defense by number 5 and number 2. That's going to be Sarita Arsham and number 5, Caitlin Gilmore. Arkola puts it back in play. Number 12. Get your feet underneath her. Paradise suits to the middle. See a good drive. Looks like we're going to call a little obstruction here. Not sure who on. That's Urkola bringing the action. Good defense that time by number 2. That's going to be Sarita Arsham. Excellent job of clearing. Duchesne turned the field pretty quick. They got it to the mid, got into the other half, but lose control. Number 2, Sarita Arsham continues to move it forward. She's doing a great job on the defensive end. They were unable to connect with Julia Cook. Number 10 for Duchesne was ready to take flight, but just couldn't quite get the stick where it needed to be. Urkola sends the ball down the near sideline. Seems like number 5, Gilmore, was ready for that action. She did a good job of controlling.
Moves out to C.C. Van Pelt, number 34. Returns to number 10, Julia Cook. Looked to send it to Montalbano, but was unable to. St. Agnes with possession. On the whistle, St. Agnes controls. Moving forward. That's Abby Kraft, number 11, to Urkola. I'm sorry, that's to number 6. Ball went back to Grace Ann McGee. She was unable to control with the shot. Drive fell a little short. Good job by number 18, James Trammell. Gilmore again, slows play. Good job. She's worked hard for the Chargers all afternoon. Urkola. She had what she was looking for. She was looking for number 3. She had Sarah Tidwell set up, unable to connect. Quick turnover. Good job by number 12, Addie Paradise. They were looking for number 9. That's Christina Ojeos on the far side, unable to connect. See if Duchesne can get something moving. On the whistle, they'll maintain possession and move forward. Montalbano, number 38, moving down the middle. They've looked for her each time down. Looks like Duchesne has their attack ready. Five minutes to play here in the first half. St. Agnes sends it deep. That's going to be number 2, Emily Schroeder. She's coming in for number 9. That's Christina Ojeos. Good job all around. Chargers in possession, 4.5 left here in the first half on the far sideline. Good attack there by St. Agnes. That was number 12, Addie Paradise, doing a good job to arrest possession. Montalbano in front of the goal, kicked away by Huring. Unable to clear, Huring with another kick save. Good defense by the Tigers. Good job that time by the St. Agnes defense. Looked like they were going to be in peril, but with 3:50 remaining in the first half, they've turned the pitch. Looked to change sides, unable to do so. Here comes number 5. It's bringing the ball up for Duchesne. Gilmore's done a good job for the Chargers today to keep moving the possessions forward. She's looking to attack every opportunity she has. Number 23, Ariel Schumacher, will set us back to play. Number 11, Abby Kraft coming off. Number 12, Addie Paradise returning. Number 21 also entering the pitch. Number 21 is going to be Sadie Niermeyer. Duchesne in control, 2.5 remaining here in the first half of play, trying to get that first goal, trying to crack the ice. We're still 0-0 with 2.5 to play. Number 10, Julia Cook, continued to attack but could not control. St. Agnes will look to clear. Number 2 continues moving forward. That's Emily Schrader.
again continues to press the attack. That was number 17, Sarah Severin, moving the ball forward. Agnes controls number 3, Sarah Tidwell. Oh, that was a great look on the far side. Number 21 thought she had, Sadie Niermeyer thought she had Tidwell return the pass, couldn't quite connect. Had a good thought and a good look, just couldn't connect it. Again, moving forward, this time going to number 21, Sadie Niermeyer. Duchesne able to defend, moving back up with 120 remaining here in the first half. Approaching the 1 minute mark. See if Duchesne makes the last charge. They do. They've got number 5 coming down this near sideline. Montalbano is there, unable to connect. Again. They're going to have an opportunity with 39 seconds remaining here in the first half. Chargers taking the play to the Tigers. See what we can do on this piece. Could be the last player possession anyway of the first half with 25 seconds remaining. Action continues. Good job by the Tigers defense, but couldn't quite clear. On the whistle, we'll do it one more time. With the horn sounding, this will definitely be the last possession of the first half. Looks like 38, Montalbano will put the ball into play. She sends deep, finds 34 into Hearing. Hearing able to keep out of the goal, another kick save. And on the whistle.
Our halftime score.
Looks like we have reached the first half of the second semifinal. St. Agnes defense has done a good job of keeping the score. They've had to defend more shots than the Chargers, but at the end of the first half, Chargers 0, Tigers 0. Field Hockey 2019 here for TAPS, semifinal number 2. Thank you for joining us on TAPS TV for this contest. We'll have the halftime opportunity for our young ladies, and we will be back with you shortly. Thank you again for joining us on TAPS TV.
Aiden loves playing baseball. He's in his element when he picks up a baseball bat.
When Aiden tore his ACL last year, we were all devastated. We didn't think that a 13-year-old could have a problem such as that.
Children's Health Andrews Institute for Orthopedic and Sports Medicine not only repaired Aiden's ACL, but they gave him the knowledge and skills to prevent any future injuries.
Now, less than a year later, he's back to hitting homers and doing phenomenal.
We're halfway through halftime, 5 minutes and 15 seconds remaining on the scoreboard clock. 5 minutes or more of halftime as we get retaped and hydrated and ready to go here for the second half. Temperature 65 degrees. The wind's still blowing 17 to 20. Good time to take a drink and get hydrated back for the second half. It's been a tough afternoon so far. Not a lot of scoring. We're 0-0 in this semifinal, but a lot of action as both teams have continued to push the action forward. We appreciate you joining us for Taps Field Hockey 2019. Thank you for joining us here on Taps TV.
Time. Just a reminder from Taps that the Field Hockey Championships are taking place Friday, October 25th and Saturday, October 26th. More of your favorite music is coming up for you here on Game Time.
This is Game Time.
I saw the life inside of you. I'm right. Tonight, you and I were beautiful like diamonds in the sky. I too, I'm so alive. We're beautiful like diamonds in the sky. Shine bright like a diamond.
Clock is winding down on halftime as we approach the horn. Second half, tied 0-0, St. Agnes and Duchesne Academy. Both teams getting ready to play. Duchesne will now defend from right to left. Duchesne in white. St. Agnes will defend from left to right. They'll be in black. Wind continues at 17 to 25 out of the right-hand side, right to left. So Duchesne will play with the wind at their back this half. We appreciate you joining us for Taps Field Hockey 2019 here on Taps TV, and we appreciate the St. Mary's Hall Barons for hosting this year's tournament. We'll be back momentarily with the start of the second half action. Like we got a little early start, but we are ready for play. St. Agnes came out on the attack. That was number 27, Barrett Wickman. Barrett Wickman here on the near side. Number 33 bringing the ball to action. Sophia Zaman. Good defense brings possession back to St. Agnes. Good job by the St. Agnes defense to turn that possession around. Looked like a good attack that time by Duchesne. On the whistle. See what Duchesne can do here. St. Agnes continues moving forward, but Duchesne was able to turn. That was number 21, Seti Niermeyer for St. Agnes. Trying to move it forward. Number 9 for St. Agnes. Christina Ojeos loses possession, but was looking to attack. Number 33, bringing the action, Sophia Zaman. Comes down the near sideline. On the whistle, possession will stay with Duchesne. Back into play. Tiger defense up to the task once again. That was number 34, Van Pelt. Unable to connect. Duchesne plays back. Here come the Tigers. Ball played to space. Looks like number 9 out there giving chase again was Christina Ojeos. She'll have the opportunity to set up the Tiger offense here. Back into play. Good defense by Duchesne, number 33. Which way does the referee serve? All two signals. Stays with St. Agnes. Good job by the Duchesne defense there. Come on, Tiger! Good battle in front of the St. Agnes bench, won by St. Agnes. Number 22 for St. Agnes. It'll be Hope Anderson. See which way she decides to go. She moves it forward down the near sideline to number 11. That was Abby Kraft trying to control. Ohio sends it in deep, but there's nobody there. Duchesne will now have possession. 24 minutes remaining here in the second half. Still tied 0-0. See which side Duchesne decides to move forward with. It's right down the middle. Gets past the first line of the defense. Pushes out wide to number 27. That's Barrett Whitman. Barrett tries to get the ball to 23 and does. Good drive. Hard drive going in. Duchesne has another opportunity from the far side. That's number 5. Caitlin Gilmore, see what she decides to do here. She puts it in play. St. Agnes bringing it down. It was a good thought to come back to the near side. A little hard and a little out of reach. Good hustle all the way. Duchesne unable to clear. In the middle, shot on goal. Just wide right. Might have been the best scoring opportunity of the game, especially here in the second half, but maybe for the whole game. Good opportunity, good look. Both teams are ready. St. Agnes puts us back into play. Good defense that time by number 5, Gilmore, to move it out to the side. Able to clear. Agnes controls. Good job by that Duchesne defense that time. They've been under attack this half, and they've done a good job. Ball gets free. That's number 21 for St. Agnes. She centered it. Sadie Niermeyer had a shot. Partner couldn't quite get it on stick. That was a good look from St. Agnes. Number 2, Emily Schrader, returning to the contest for St. Agnes. Number 9, Christina Ojeos comes out. Agnes continued on the attack. See if Duchesne can clear. See where Duchesne decides to place this one. See which side they're going to attack. They've been going down the middle. Again, go straight down the middle. Urkola goes deep. See if Duchesne can clear. They can. They're able to control. And able to clear. That was number 3, Sarah Tidwell. Tidwell unable to attack in advance to goal. Ball goes out. Looks like it goes off to Shin. We'll have number 2, Emily Schrader. See what Schrader can do here. Come on, Duchesne on the attack. Able to clear to the near side. Out to number 27. That's Wickman. Good kick to save possession. Deering was able to get out of immediate danger, but now she'll face another possession here. Good drive. Off to the right-hand side of goal. Good attack. Way to pressure the defense that time by Duchesne. Duchesne will get a good opportunity here.
Let's go, defense!
Montalbano surveys the situation, puts us back into play. It's set, 23 with the drive. Good defense that time by St. Agnes. Duchesne again attacking, drive from far. Good defense. Whistle was blown. Duchesne will have another opportunity here. It's number 23, bring us to play. Unable to drive through. Number 21 for St. Agnes looks to move down the field. Sadie Niermeyer trying to bring the action. Duchesne able to convert. That's number 5 on the far side. Gilmore does a good job, unable to convert. Timeout on the field with 15:34 remaining in the second half. 15:34 remaining in the second half. Our score remains tied 0-0. Thank you for joining us for this semifinal action on Taps TV.
A school team is family. Traveling team, they also still family. But once you finish the season, we all split apart. We don't ever come during the season together unless we compete against each other. But other than that, school team is like, it's family to me, and I consider that a prized possession.
as we come out of the timeout with 15:34 remaining in the contest. Both teams are ready. Goalies making their way back. Officials seem ready. Action will begin momentarily. Good job by the Charger defense to slow that pace down a little bit. St. Agnes unable to connect. See what the Chargers can do. Chargers look to push forward. That was number 12, Addie Paradise, unable to connect on a shot, but she put the action to him. St. Agnes is going to have another shot here from the far sideline. Drive found nobody home on the other end. See what the Tigers do. Number 11, Abby Kraft, replaces number 12, Addie Paradise on the pitch for the Tigers. Tigers looking to move forward. That's number 3. It's going to be Sarah Tidwell. Officials signals Tiger possession. Good job by Sarita Arsham to try to bring the action. Unfortunately goes out over the sideline. So Urkola will have an opportunity to set the Agnes offense. Kraft. Number 21 giving chase. That's Sarah. Sadie Niemeyer's done a lot of running today, side to side. She's gotten a lot of them. Couldn't quite get to that one. See what Duchesne has in store for us going the other way. Emily Schrader for St. Agnes pushes forward. There was an opportunity there just out of the reach of number 11, Abby Kraft, and just out of the far side as well. They had it set up, just couldn't quite connect. It was a good look. Good look, good attack. Played through. Attack coming from the near side. Let's see what the Tigers can do with this piece. Number 11, Abby Kraft. Here we go. Swing it around the top. Good defense by Duchesne. They slow the action. Agnes maintains possession, but at least there wasn't a shot. Good job by the Duchesne Charger defense. Tigers were looking for Urkola. Had an opportunity, but not able to convert yet. Good defense so far by Duchesne. Good job by the defenders to clear that. And out off the sideline, off the stick of number 22. So it'll roll over to the Tigers to come out. Molly Thompson couldn't quite control, but she's been very active today. Good job. Tigers making a substitution. We have number 6, Grace Ann McGee, coming off, and number 15, Olivia Walden, entering the pitch. Walden comes in, barely misses an opportunity with the stick. Abby Kraft, good job of control. Back in action we are. That was Urkola. Is she unable to get through? We have 6 minutes and 13 seconds remaining. A little over 6 minutes here in the second half. Our score still 0-0.
going to be another timeout taken. So with 6 minutes exactly remaining in the second half, 6 minutes of the second semifinal, Chargers 0, Tigers 0, Taps Field Hockey 2019 here on Taps TV. Thank you for joining us. Referee's whistle brings us back into play. 6 minutes remaining here in the second half of our second semifinal. Agnes and Duchesne, both schools, seeing what they can get started. Duchesne on the offensive. Good job of defense there by number 22 for St. Agnes. Hope Anderson. Hope's been busy this afternoon. Couldn't quite clear there. Duchesne maintains possession. Duchesne comes up the near sideline. Gets almost to the corner. Good attack that time. That was number 33 for Duchesne. Zaman has done a good job from this near side. Ariel Schumacher surveys the situation. Which way is she going to go? Sends it back towards the middle. Montalbano was there. Good defensive stop. Good job on defense that time by the Tigers. That's Urkola. Tigers now move downfield a little too hard, a little too outside on that one at 4:28 remaining in the second half. Shin gets it set. They've got a plan. 4 minutes to go. They bring it back to the near side. Unable to connect. 27. That was Barrett Wickman giving chase. They had a good idea to change the field, but unable to connect. Tigers looking. That's number 17, Sarah Severin. Quick whistle. The wind has picked up again. Duchesne's giving chase, unable to catch up. It's a good thought and a good look, just unable to attack that way. Montalbano looks in. Good defense to control. That's Urkola.
Number 34, C.C. Van Pelt, had a thought but couldn't quite finish. St. Agnes had numbers, unable to advance. Good job on the defense that time. Looked like that was number two. Sarita Arsham on the far side slowed the whole thing down by herself. She was outnumbered, but she stood her ground. Clock still running. 2 minutes. 2 minutes to remain here in the second half. 2 minutes to decide the second semifinal between the St. Agnes Tigers and the Duchesne Chargers. Officials having a great conversation. See which way they go after they get done. Officials ready. Players getting ready. From all indications, St. Agnes has this opportunity. Able to play all the way to this near side. Moving forward. A little too hard on the official signal. Duchesne will have a chance to take advantage here with 140 remaining. She's not able to control St. Agnes, and they're in. Number 17, quick Sarah Severin, quick to put the ball in play. Duchesne continues on the whistle, obstruction. That's number 23 for the Chargers. Good job by Ariel Schumacher. She's been active all day long. See where she chooses to go. She tried to reset as well. She was looking for number five on the far side, but Caitlin Gilmore couldn't quite connect. Come on, 55 seconds remaining in regulation. Duchesne remains aggressive, moving the ball to the near side. Good fight for the ball at the mid. Both teams unwilling to give. It's going to be Duchesne's possession with 30 seconds remaining. Continues, good fight by the defense of St. Agnes. Moves to the center, St. Agnes is able to clear. Urkola on the whistle, St. Agnes. 18 seconds remaining. See if they choose to play it safe for attack. They look to attack. She was looking for number 21. Niemeyer unable to control. Ojeos looked for it, but only 5 seconds remaining. Won't be time unless there's penalty. That's the end of regulation. End of regulation tied 0-0. St. Agnes Tigers 0, Duchesne Chargers 0 at the end of regulation. Have a brief intermission, then we'll come back. See who's going to decide this second semifinal to find out who will play the Fort Worth All Saints Saints in tomorrow's championship and who will play the St. Mary's Hall Barons for the third place opportunity. Thank you again for joining us on TAPS TV. It's number 34 for Duchesne, CeCe Van Pelt, and number 22, Hope Anderson for St. Agnes, meeting with the officials as we prepare to go to 7-a-side. Clock will be reset here in approximately 2.5 minutes. We'll go to sudden death, see who's going to win this opportunity to face the Fort Worth All Saints Saints in tomorrow's championship and who will play for third place against the St. Mary's Hall Barons. Thank you again for joining us today on Taps TV for Field Hockey 2019.
I play basketball and softball. Basketball is more just like that sport. Like, I just can't give up because, like, I've always loved it also. It's just not my best sport. I love the girls on the team, and I just enjoy the sport in general. And it's good to get, like, a break from softball. If I don't want to get burned out from it, because when I get that two-month, three-month break playing basketball for my high school, it gives me time to, like, really miss it, and then so when I come back, I'm like ready to go and like wanting to work even harder.
Clock winds down to zero. We'll have that 10-minute overtime, 7 on each side, looking to see who's going to decide and move on. 0-0 is our current score as we go to overtime between the Duchesne Chargers and the Tigers from St. Agnes. Thank you for joining us for today's second semifinal for Field Hockey 2019 on Taps TV. Officials' whistle brings us to the overtime period. See what kind of a charge Duchesne can get going here. Brought to the near side to number 34. That's going to be CeCe Van Pelt. CeCe makes the turn. Maintains control. Good job of moving there one-on-one.
drive stopped by number 22. But control remains with Duchesne. Back to CC Van Pelt. Van Pelt returns to 23. Ariel Schumacher. Duchesne will maintain an opportunity here. See what kind of aggressive opportunity they take, or whether they play more to the space. The wind's picked up. Montalbano looking to put the ball in play. Number 38 for Duchesne. Straight down the middle. Gets past her teammate. Tigers look to advance. On the whistle, Chargers have another opportunity. It looked like the Tigers might be able to turn the table there, but they were unable to complete it. Ball moves forward to Montalbano. The drive in deep was failed to connect with the teammate. Moving forward now. Good job that time. Number 34, Van Pelt. Van Pelt, good aggressive move. Wins the situation. Number 23, Schumacher, goes far side to number 5. Good look to Gilmore. Gilmore able to control, makes the turn. Drive to the middle to Montalbano. Could not connect there. Think they had what they wanted. They were just unable to finish it. Urkola drives the ball deep. Agnes maintains. Duchesne gets numbers back for defense. Duchesne's midfielders have done a good job all day long in their defenders. St. Agnes has had very few attacks. Montalbano turns. See what Agnes can do now. Abby Kraft is set for the Tigers to re-enter. Great chase that time by Van Pelt. She almost got to the pass. It would have been hard to defend on that if she had. Tigers maintain control. Number 9, Ohaos, she's able to control for a minute until Duchesne attacks. Now Duchesne brings back upfield, comes back upfield. Good job by Tiger defense number 22. That was Hope Anderson. She wins the possession. Ball goes to Urkola in the middle. She loses control. Duchesne on the near sideline. That's number 33. That's going to be Zaman. Zaman, she's got Montalbano in the middle. Didn't find her. St. Agnes drives deep, but it goes out. Number 23, Ariel Schumacher. See where she chooses to go this time. Went short, controls herself, then tried to center. Montalbano gives chase, Van Pelt gives chase. Ultimately, the ball won by number 22, Hope Anderson. Anderson just barely misconnected. She had Abby Kraft ready. Number 13, Mimi Reedy into play. 13 for the St. Agnes Tigers, Mimi Reedy. Clock is run to under 5. We're at 4 minutes 50 seconds remaining in this overtime period. Go, Tiger! Tigers able to sneak that one through. It's going to be 3-on-2 if they can continue forward. Good job by the defense of the Duchesne Chargers. They were able to turn the tide. Good defense that time by number 2, Sarita Arsham. Good job all the way around. Numbers were in the Tigers' favor as they came across the half. Urkola looks to move the ball in to number 11, Abby Kraft. Duchesne's able to clear. They get out of danger, send the ball out wide. On the whistle, number 9, Christina Ojeos will enter the play. See where she chooses to go. May go short. She does. Unable to play through. Good job by Duchesne. Montalbano giving chase. And her presence is felt. She's able to obtain possession momentarily until Arcola enters field. Tigers continue to give chase. Good defense. 3 minutes remaining. 3 minutes, 0-0. Charger ball. See what the Chargers can do here from the near side. Quickly turned over. Number 9, Ojeos, moves in for the Tigers. She drives down deep, but there's nobody there. I think she thought she had Kraft making a run. Two 30-minute halves, an overtime, and an intermission, and we're 2 minutes to go here, 2.5 minutes to go into the 10-minute overtime. Legs may not be as fresh as they were a few minutes ago. Urkola wins the ball. See where she goes with it. She's got a hard drive in her somewhere. She's trying to line it up. She's moving down. She gets it, plays it through. Good job by the defense that time. That was number 2. It's going to be Sarita Arsham for the Chargers. Excellent job of defense. Single-handedly got them out of trouble and now bringing them back down on the offense. Subs, number 2 and number 6, Emily Schrader and Grace Ann McGee come on to play for the Tigers. It's an offensive opportunity for Duchesne. Good stop that time by Huring. Duchesne had the run on. Unable to stop. Huring did a good job to deflect out. Number 11, Abby Kraft comes off. Number 3, Sarah Tidwell enters the field. Hard fought both ways. 120 remaining in overtime. First extra period, 120 remaining. It's going to be number 23 putting us into play. Schumacher goes wide. Good defense by the Tigers. We've got under a minute. We're at 57 seconds remaining here in the overtime period. Duchesne has time for one more attack. Trying to reset ball position. 40 seconds remaining. 40 seconds remaining. Duchesne. That's number 5. Gilmore puts it into play to the far side. 33, Zaman does a good job, but she loses control. Here we come with Gilmore right back. Gilmore brings it to the middle. Able to clear. St. Agnes clears. 15 seconds remaining. Duchesne has chance. 10 seconds. See how far they can get it in. They do. They got it to Montalbano, but she couldn't control. Hard fought on the far side by Zaman, 33. Couldn't get a shot off. Time expires here in the overtime period. Score remains 0-0 after the overtime. We'll go to a 5-minute intermission in between overtime periods.
wonderful time while we play some great music here on Game Time. The performances you will see are the result of many hours of preparation. All of the students have worked hard for your entertainment and appreciation. Please encourage them by your cheers, your applause, and your good sportsmanship. These students, along with their directors and coaches, represent their school with pride and honor. Another winning song is coming up here on Game Time.
I would say there's nothing more important in life than learning how to present something that you want people to know. There's nothing more important than the ability to say, this is what I believe, what do you believe, and how can we reach a consensus? Whether you're an actor, an athlete, a business person, you need to know how to do that.
Burns. They'll be playing in the third place game tomorrow. The winner of today's contest here in semifinal number two between the Duchesne Chargers and the St. Agnes Tigers will play All Saints Episcopal School of Fort Worth for the championship. Thank you again for joining us on Taps TV as we move towards the conclusion of this game. We're still tied 0-0. We have 2:30 remaining in the intermission. Sit back and wait for an exciting finish. It's been 0-0 now for 70 minutes. Thank you again for joining us on Taps TV.
This is Game Time.
Our teams change sides as we move forward. 30 seconds left before the resuming of play. Duchesne wearing white will be defending the left goal. To our right, we will have the Tigers of St. Agnes. Thank you for joining us here for Field Hockey 2019, brought to you on Taps TV from the home of the Barons, St. Mary's Hall in San Antonio. Schumacher gives to Gilmore. Gilmore comes down the right-hand side. She had a good no look. She was looking for number 33, Zaman, but unable to connect. Now the Tigers give chase. See if they can do something towards the offensive end. Unable to control. Duchesne brings the ball back into the offensive end. Number 18, Trammell, able to clear.
Number 5, Gilmore. Number 33, Zaman. Number 21 from St. Agnes, that's Sadie Niemeyer, brings it up. Number 2, giving chase, see if she can get there before it goes out. Unable to, just a touch away. Excellent hustle there by Emily Schrader. Arsham looked to play back across to Gilmore, and she does. Good attack that time by number 21 for St. Agnes. Urkola able to get a stick on down. Good turn that time by Zaman. Zaman returns. Good pass. See where she goes to the far side. She's got Van Pelt on the left. She looks to go to Van Pelt, unable to control. Then Montalbano coming straight down the middle. St. Agnes again on the attack. Seven minutes remaining here in the second overtime. St. Agnes will control. It's going to be number 22, Hope Anderson. She chooses to go down the far sideline. CC Van Pelt almost had an attack because she had Montalbano coming on the backside. Big swing and a miss. Urkola comes up the middle. We have an attack on the far side by number 3, Sarah Tidwell. Good defense by number 2 to at least slow the attack. Number 2 was Sarita Arsham. She's been very active on the defensive end. She didn't have much choice there. It's going to be 1v1 with the goal. Tigers have to take a deep breath and figure out what they're going to do here. Emily Schrader surveys the field. Let's see what she chooses to do. Goes to Urkola. Urkola with a hard drive from the outside. Duchesne controls. Duchesne sets. Urkola again. Good drive in. Urkola. Sent to 21, which is Sadie Niemeyer. Couldn't quite control. It was an excellent look to the side. Unselfish play that time by Urkola. She had a runner and just could not quite connect. It's going to be number 5 this time. Gilmore looking to push up. She has Montalbano running through. Montalbano she's a yard and a half away from collecting that one. It would have been dangerous on the keeper, but she couldn't quite get there. We're down to 4:50 remaining in this overtime period. 4:50 remaining in the 7-on-7. Seven aside out there. This time number 2 drives forward to number 3. Last time it was 3-2. So this is going to be Sarah Tidwell. Tidwell number 3 coming up the far side. Able to control. Finally on the whistle. Possession will go back. Number 2, that's going to be Sarita Arsham again on the defense, and she'll send it into play. Ooh, As soon as an opportunity arises, Abby Kraft, number 11 for St. Agnes, will re-enter play. Hercola sends across, number 18, Trammell. Trammell unable to control. Trammell giving chase. Trammell controls. On the whistle, stays with Duchesne. Duchesne puts the ball in play. They find Montalbano. She's by herself. They go deep to the right-hand side. Nobody there to run. Go out of bounds. 3:35 remaining here in the overtime period. Kraft is returned, and so will Ojeos, number 9 returning. Number 9 for number 2. Schrader comes off. Schrader and Tidwell off. Abby Kraft and Olivia Ojeos in. Here comes the run by number 11. She tried to go forward. If she could have got it through, she had a good opportunity. Kraft was thinking ahead. This is Urkola. She has a shot. She has a stick. Good drive forward. Looks like Trammell right in the middle of it. Trammell resets. Goes wide. Urkola is there. It's number 21 for the Tigers. Good kick save. 21 will have another opportunity. Missed to the left. 21. That's Sadie Niemeyer. Had two opportunities there in his overtime period that could have sent the Tigers onto the championship game. We have 2:23 remaining here in the second overtime period. 2:23 remaining. Good job that time by the keeper. Able to keep things in check. Good job by Camille Loeb. Here we go. Van Pelt, Montalbano, what can they do together? Urkola able to stop the advance. Urkola wins the opportunity. 2 minutes remaining. 2 minutes remaining. Van Pelt comes back to Zaman. Zaman to Gilmore. Gilmore has Montalbano up front. Unable to get the ball through. Continues her attack. No stopping Gilmore. She's still maintaining control. Van Pelt. Ball pops up on the whistle. Duchesne will have an opportunity here. 1:25 remaining in the second overtime period. 1:25-0-0. It is sudden death. If they can score here, it will be the contest. Looks forward. St. Agnes has possession with right at a minute remaining. By the time they set possession, it'll be a minute to go. Urkola. Gilmore unable to control. Here comes Urkola. She's on the run. Ball gets through. If she can get it centered, she has someone down there. Urkola looks ahead. That's number 11, Trammell, in the middle. Number 21 for the Tigers took the shot. That was Sadie Niemeyer. She has another shot here in the second overtime period. That's three in the last minute. 30 seconds remaining. 30 seconds remaining. Maybe the last possession as Urkola tees it up. Was looking wide, looking to go back to number 21 again, looking to go to Niemeyer. Seems like that was the shot they wanted. Urkola controls. She's able to spin, gets through, still in the lane. Coming down this near side, see if she can find a partner. On the whistle, Duchesne has an opportunity with 3, 2, 1, and time will expire. Time has expired in the second overtime period of this thrilling second semifinal here at Taps Field Hockey 2019. Thank you again for joining us on Taps TV for this field hockey opportunity in 2019.
Aiden loves playing baseball. He's in his element when he picks up a baseball bat.
When Aiden tore his ACL last year, we were all devastated. We didn't think that a 13-year-old could have a problem such as that.
Children's Health Andrews Institute for Orthopedic and Sports Medicine not only repaired Aiden's ACL, but they gave him the knowledge and skills to prevent any future injuries.
Now, Less than a year later, he's back to hitting homers and doing phenomenal.
Time. Just a reminder from Taps that the Field Hockey Championships are taking place Friday, October 25th and Saturday, October 26th. More of your favorite music is coming up for you here on Game Time. I want to see you go.
Two halves of play, two overtime periods, two zeros on the scoreboard. Duchesne Chargers 0, St. Agnes Tigers 0 as we approach the shootout opportunity to determine this contest. Been a great contest here this afternoon. Shadows are lengthening a little bit, but we're going to finish this out strong. It's been a good, well-played game by both keepers. Both keepers have kept the scoreboard at 0. Now we'll see which end we're going to shoot from and who's going to shoot. We'll call them as they go. We appreciate you joining us for Taps Field Hockey 2019 here in our second semifinal. We appreciate the opportunity to bring this contest to you here on Taps TV.
Racing.
Looks like with the motion of the fans, we'll be taking our shootout towards the right-hand goal into the wind. So it'll be an opportunity here momentarily. Shootout. Both goalies, Loeb and Huring, have the opportunity. Both seem ready. Both seem prepared. Both been supported by their teammates as they get ready for this opportunity. See how they come out. Teams go to meet with the officials. We'll see how this comes to conclusion. It's been a great, well-played game. Second semifinal of Taps Field Hockey 2019. Zeros on the scoreboard. 80 minutes of play on the field, and it'll all come down to this, the shootout. Appreciate you joining us on Taps TV for the shootout. We'll call the action as they return here momentarily. Thanks again for joining us for Taps Field Hockey 2019.
We've got some great music to go along with the excitement here on Game Time. Get ready to enjoy the special performances of the talented students from these two fine schools. The score of any athletic event is generally forgotten over time, but the actions of the players, coaches, and spectators are remembered. The next time you attend a high school game, think of how history will remember you. Good sports show you how to play the game. Another winning song is coming up on Game Time.
It comes down to Camille Loeb, goaltender, keeper for the Chargers at Duchesne. And it's going to come down to Hannah Huring, the goalkeeper for the Tigers of St. Agnes. Both appear ready, both wearing orange. See who can pull this one out and send their team to the championship and whose team will go to the third place game. Loeb for Duchesne will be the first one tested. She takes her spot. Officials seem ready. Number 12, it's going to be Addie Paradise. Number 12 will be the first shooter for St. Agnes. Ball set ready for play. Keeper ready. Player ready. We're underway. And it's a save. Good job, Miss Loeb. Hannah Huring takes her spot. Looks like it's going to be number 5 for Duchesne. Number 5 is going to be Caitlin Gilmore. Very active today. Let's see what she has left right here. Officials are ready. Player and keeper are ready. Here we go. Keeper goes down. Shot goes wide. It's a miss. Zero, zero the score on the board. Zero, zero the score in the shootout.
Camille Loeb returns to the box. Looks like it's going to be that was number six, Grace Ann McGee. We remain knotted at zero. As Hannah Huring returns as keeper. It's going to be number 34, C.C. Van Pelt, bringing it on Huring. Here it goes. She's been active and has a shot. She scores. C.C. Van Pelt, number 34, puts Duchesne ahead 1-0 after two shooters. Camille Loeb has a little lead, has a little opportunity here. See if she can get the stop. Sadie Niermeyer brings it in. Loeb comes out. It's a good stop. Twice. No goal. Number 21, stoned. Brings Huring back into the box. It's going to be number 33, Zaman. 33's Sophia Zaman shooting for the Duchesne Chargers. On the whistle, she charges. Huring comes out. Huring makes the save. Ball goes in. It's a score. Zaman puts the shin up. 2-0. 2-0. Augustina Urkola needs to score here for the St. Agnes Tigers. Number 8, Urkola, with the shot coming forth against Camille Loeb. See if Loeb is up to the task. On the whistle, here comes Urkola. Shot is blocked. See if she can turn and get another. Time expires. Duchesne. Duchesne, 2-0 in the shootout. They will advance to tomorrow's championship game. Duchesne Academy will play All Saints Episcopal School in our championship game. St. Agnes Academy will play our host, St. Mary's Hall, in the third place game tomorrow. Join us back here from San Antonio on Taps TV for the conclusion of the Taps Field Hockey 2019 tournament. Thank you again for joining us on Taps TV today as we brought you the two semifinal games live from San Antonio. Good luck to both Duchesne and All Saints in the championship and St. Mary's Hall and St. Agnes in the third place contest. Thank you again, St. Mary's Hall, for hosting us. Good luck to all of our players tomorrow. Thank you for joining us here on Taps TV.